remember the times that you have held your head high and told all your friends of your Indian claim. Proud good lady and proud good man, your great-great-grandfather from Indian blood sprang, and you feel in your heart for these ones. Oh, it's written in books and in songs that we've been mistreated and wronged. Well, over and over I hear the same words from you, good lady, and you, good man. Germany fell to your hands. Consider, dear lady, consider, dear man. You left them their pride and you left them their land. And what have you done to these ones? Has a change come about, Uncle Sam? Or are you still taking our lands? A treaty forever, George Washington signed. He did, dear lady, he did, dear man. And the treaty's being broken by Kim's or Dam. And what will you do for these ones? Oh, it's all in the past, you can say, but it's still going on here today. The government now wants the Iroquois land, that of the Seneca and the Cheyenne. It's here and it's now, you must help us, dear man. Now that the buffalo's gone. Now that your big eyes are finally open, now that you're wondering how must they feel, meaning them that you've chased across America's movie screens. Now that you're wondering how can it be real that the ones you've called colorful, noble, and proud in your school propaganda, they starve in their splendor. You've asked for my comment, I simply will render. My country, 'tis of thy people you're dying. Now that the longhouses breed superstition, you force us to send our toddlers away to your schools, where they're taught to despise their traditions, forbid them their languages, then further say that American history really began when Columbus set sail out of Europe, and stress that the nation of leeches that's conquered this land are the biggest and bravest and boldest and best. And yet where in your history books is the tale of the genocide basic to this country's birth, of the preachers who lied, how the Bill of Rights failed, how a nation of patriots return to their earth? And where will it tell of the Liberty Bell as it rang with a thud over Kinzoa mud, and a brave Uncle Sam in Alaska this year? My country, 'tis of thy people you're dying. Hear how the bargain was made for your land. So the treaty's a test. Oh, well, blankets for land is a bargain indeed. And the blankets were those Uncle Sam had collected from smallpox disease, dying soldiers that day. And the tribes were wiped out, and the history books censored. 100 years of your statesmen have felt it's better this way. Yet a few of the conquered have somehow survived. Their blood runs the redder, though genes have been paled. From the Grand Canyon's caverns to Craven's sad hills, the wounded, the losers, the robbed sing their tale. From Los Angeles County to upstate New York, the white nation fattens while others grow lean. Oh, the tricked and evicted, they know what I mean. My country, 'tis of thy people you're dying. The past, it just crumbled. The future just threatens. Our lifeblood shut up in your chemical tanks. And now here you come, bill of sale in your hand, and surprise in your eyes that we're lacking in thanks for the blessings of civilization you've brought us, the lessons you've taught us, the ruin you've wrought us. Oh, see what our trust in America's bought us. My country, 'tis of thy people you're dying. Now that the pride of the sires receives charity, now that we're harmless and safe behind laws, now that my life's to be known as your heritage, now that even the graves have been robbed, now that our own chosen way is a novelty, hands on our hearts, we salute you, your choke on your blue, white, and scarlet hypocrisy, pitying the blindness that you've never seen. That the eagles
weren't very many movie stars that I could look to as role models. It is hard to think of Marlon as a role model for anybody, at least for a woman. But you know, he had taken a very active stand in support of Native Americans and in support of Black Panthers who were in jail. And I was interested in those issues, and it was to Marlon that I turned to get information and to talk.
And myself included. And of course he got a lot of flack from it, you know.
His life was threatened. You know, he went to jail for it.
Are you in Washington at the Negro March? And here you are backing the Indians' problem. How come?
Well, I feel that a great many things recently in our country have come to light, and the condition of the Negro generally was not known. And the condition, I'm amazed about with the ignorance that I see concerning the Indian, because most scholarly people, the most informed people, the intellectuals, the academicians know nothing about the American Indian.